afternoon, TOP Nation, and welcome to TOP and Be Inspired in 5. I am Elder Coleman with a nugget for you today. The nugget is coming from the 5th chapter of John, verses 6 through 9, and I'm going to read that in your hearing. When Jesus saw him lie and knew that he had been there a long time in that case, he saith unto him, "Will thou be made whole?" The impotent man answered him, "Sir, I have no man when the water is troubled to put me into the pool, but while I am coming, another steppeth down before me." Jesus said unto him, "Rise, take up thy bed, and walk." And immediately the man was made whole, and he took up his bed and walked. And we're going to stop there today. And the nugget for today is, will thou be made whole? Now, in this passage of scripture, we see that Jesus asked a question to a man who had laid by a pool for 38 years. That is a long time. And some of us have dealt with issues for a while. Beloved brother, our Father does not desire that we deal with these issues for a long period of time. In the 11th chapter of Matthew, verses 28, he says, "Come unto me, all ye that labor and are heavy laden, and I will give you rest. I will deliver you. I will set you free. I will heal you." Whatever it is that you stand in need of, when we go before the Father in prayer, when we search the word of God to find the promise that will meet our need, and we put this before the Father in prayer, he hears us and will answer our prayers. In this particular passage, you know, we don't have time for excuses. We don't have to try to figure out what's going on. We can go to our Father in prayer. We can meet him, and he will meet us in the area of our need. When we look at the woman with the issue of blood, she had an issue for 12 long years, but she made up her mind, "If I can just touch the hem of his garment, I know that I will be made whole." And through her determination, with her faith, she pressed her way. She pressed her way through the crowd. She pressed her way through her pain, through her discomfort, and she touched the hem of his garment. And the virtue of Jesus was received by her because of her faith. Now, we can touch God through our prayers. We can go before the throne of grace, the throne of mercy, and we can obtain help in our time of need. Whatever you're dealing with, Jesus came that we may have life more abundantly. That means life to the full and life to overflowing. So we don't have to carry around burdens. We have a God who is a burden bearer, who is a promise keeper, who is just waiting to deliver you and to help you in your time of need. One thing we have to remember is that we are God's chosen one. He is our heavenly Father. And just as he called the woman daughter, who had the issue of blood, he said, "Daughter, your faith has made you whole." Because we are his children, because we are joint heirs with Jesus Christ. We are his children, and he loves us, and he desires to give us the desires of our heart. He desires to heal us. He desires to deliver us, and he desires to set us free. Just as he told that man that lay by the pool for 38 years to rise up, take up your bed and walk, it is time for you to rise up, take up your bed and walk. Walk into your healing, walk into your deliverance, walk into your freedom with Jesus Christ. May God bless you. May you have a blessed and prosperous day. In Jesus' name, amen.